The mutual authentication protocol takes 5 steps. Can we simplify it? That is, can we use fewer steps? It seems that the following would work. First, Alice says hi to Bob and sends along a challenge or two. Second, in response, Bob sends Alice the ciphertext of R2 and his own challenge R1. Upon receiving this response, Alice decrypts the ciphertext to see if it matches the plaintext R2 that she has sent to Bob. If it matches, then she knows that she is communicating with Bob. Third, Alice then sends Bob the ciphertext of R1, and Bob decrypts it and matches it with the plaintext R1 to authenticate Alice. Is there anything wrong with this simplified protocol? It turns out that there is a reflection attack, a kind of man-in-the-middle attacks. Here's how it works. First, Trudy impersonates Alice. By following the protocol, Trudy will be stuck at step 3 because she cannot encrypt the challenge R1 sent from Bob. She does not have the key, KAB. Then Trudy simply opens another connection with Bob and again impersonating Alice. This time, Trudy sends Bob the challenge R1 that Bob has sent her in the first connection, the one that she's stuck in. According to the protocol, Bob responds with the ciphertext of R1 and another challenge R3. Notice that Bob has sent the ciphertext of R1 to Alice. So what Trudy can do is to take the ciphertext of R1, then Trudy can now go back to the step 3 of the first connection and send it back to Bob to complete the first connection. That is, at this point, the first connection successfully concludes and Trudy has successfully impersonated Alice. This is called a reflection attack because Trudy simply sends back to Bob what Bob had just sent her from another connection. So, how can we prevent reflection attacks? One way is to use 2 different shared keys. One is for the initiator of the connection, say Alice, and the other is for the responder, say Bob. The result is that the ciphertext that Trudy gets from Bob cannot be presented as a ciphertext from Alice because these 2 ciphertexts should be using 2 different keys. That is, there are 2 shared keys being used. Say Alice used KAB1 and Bob used KAB2. Therefore, the ciphertext from Bob is encrypted using KAB2 and Bob is going to expect a ciphertext using KAB1. Therefore, even though Trudy can intercept this ciphertext, but this ciphertext is produced using KAB2. She cannot simply send it back to Bob because the ciphertext sent to Bob must be encrypted using KAB1. Another way to prevent the reflection attack is to use different challenges for the initiator and the responder. For example, we can use even number challenge for Alice and odd number for Bob. Therefore, when Trudy receives a challenge R1 from Bob, the challenge is an odd number, and Trudy cannot use this as a new challenge for Bob because Bob is expecting an even number.